Hey y'all, welcome to Toast It Up. It's your girl Lisa Monet, all about the Monet, all right? I'm sitting in for Amia Elliott. I hope everything's all right. Tonight we're gonna do a big group. They're called the Three Kings. You know, very, very talented R&B group. You know, so, I want to start off with bringing Tiger. One of the members of the Three Kings. Hello, Tiger.
How you doing?
I'm all right, you know, toasted.
Yeah, let's toast it.
There you go.
Oh, you can't toast with me drinking water. You're drinking water. You hot?
Yeah.
You parched?
The parched.
Oh, okay, alright.
Thanks for giving me the concert. I'm good.
You got it. Okay, well, you know, all about peace and love. Let's get higher on our own vibes, baby. Alright? So, you know, we're here just celebrating and supporting our new artists, our upcoming artists, models, singers, rappers, etc. You know, anybody out there currently chasing a bag, you'd probably be contact for this show. Today, we have a special guest. We have Tiger, ladies and gentlemen, from, he's a member from the Three Kings, right?
Yes.
How you doing, Tiger?
All right.
You know, did you find your way over here okay?
Yeah, I found my way good.
Okay.
I'm familiar with these areas.
Oh, you're familiar with this area, okay. So tell me, Tiger, how long have you been singing?
Oh, since I was 5 years old.
5 years old?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, okay. So, and how old are you now?
39.
Wow, so if I do my math right, carry the one, that's about 34 years.
Yes, it is.
Oh, wow, so I guess I'm safe to say, like, this is a passion for you, not just a hobby,
it's
right?
It's a passion.
Okay, all right. So, you know, you said 5 years old. Did somebody, like, who was your greatest influence?
Boyz II Men.
Boyz II Men, okay.
I will say New Edition.
New Edition.
112, Juvenile.
Oh, okay. Maybe some classics, okay.
So.
Right, okay. And so you say, like, nothing but groups. So you started the solo thing and then ended up thinking, like, let me start a group, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And where did you get the name Three Kings from? Where did y'all get the name?
I feel as though, like, all three of us, we've been doing singing for a long time, so put it this way, like, we are king at it. We've been doing it for decades.
Okay.
Especially me and John and Rasheen. So,
so y'all king at this. Forget the prince part, right? Y'all said the prince is king. I know that's right. Okay. Don't got time to be no prince. All right. I like that. Okay. So, all right. So, it's all three of y'all. Now let me ask you, far as family wise, who was your biggest influence?
My mother.
Your mother. She's the one who told you, like, when you were five, like.
Actually, my father, he was a singer, uncle was too as well. So, at the age of five, I was just looking at them,
looking at each other.
So that would inspired me to become a singer.
Okay. Were they in groups as well?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So. Understand. So who became, when you started singing, of course you did the solo thing for a little bit before you decided to get the group, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who was your manager at the time?
His name was Tim Howard, when I was doing my solo project.
Okay. And how old were you when you started your first solo project?
I said like 26.
26? Okay. Mm-hmm. So from 5 to 26, you just dabbled, you tried it. Did you do any talent shows?
A lot of talent shows, a lot of fashion shows, and a lot of open mics and stuff.
Okay. All right.
And we also do a lot of karaoke as well.
All right. Now, did you hit your manager up or did he like scout you out?
He just hit me up.
He hit you up and you heard some of your material and everything. Okay. So are you like do you like to find your own beats? Are you an original beat person or do you like to do remakes?
I do like original beats.
Like cover songs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you like original beat stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. That's understandable. All right. So, and are you the oldest or the youngest of your group?
I'm the youngest.
The youngest of your group at 39. Okay. So it's safe to say that you guys have a tight bond.
Mm-hmm. Great tight bond.
Okay, so but it's always gonna be loyalty over royalty though, right?
Pretty much.
Okay. Just making sure, you know, you get in a group and then you see a lot of people separate and they were have a great bond before all the fame and the fortune came. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I wish y'all nothing but the best in life, peace, love and success. But do you have any workout on any channels like YouTube, SoundCloud?
We on SoundCloud and YouTube.
Okay, SoundCloud and YouTube. All right, y'all heard that, ladies. They're on SoundCloud and YouTube. Any songs you want to throw out there that's a hit, you know, that's a banger that they'll enjoy?
Yeah, the one newest single we just came out, You Are The One.
You Are The One? Mm-hmm. Now, is it more of an R&B feel?
R&B
or is it
feel, like, so.
Oh, okay, all right. So you want to get your R&B on, you know, step in the name of, oh, let me stop. But if you want to get your R&B on, you know. Say it again, what's the name for?
You Are The One.
You Are The One, all right, You Are The One, all right. So, Tiger, tell me, do you have a special lady in your life?
Oh, my God, yeah, she's especially dear to my heart right now.
Oh, okay. So, I'm feeling the vibe. All right. Special lady, shout out to you. So, you want to give her a shout out to
Nate? Shout out to Elizabeth.
Oh, okay. And how did y'all meet?
High school.
High school?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so y'all was high school sweethearts.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And that was about what? 20 years ago. All right. So, y'all been going strong. Shout out to Black Love. Love it. Okay. All right. So, how did you get her?
That's how she get me.
Oh, she got you.
She ran across me in the hallway in the locker.
Oh, she knew what she want, huh?
Yeah, so she started smiling at me, and I'm like, okay, why is this girl smiling at me?
Uh-huh.
And so she was having trouble with her locker, so I ended up banging on it, and it opened up. And so that's how she just caught my eyes. And no matter what people, what's the experience they think about her, I saw something more than anybody ever did.
Right.
Because I knew her past, and I knew what she was going through.
Right.
So that would make her be a part of my life.
Right.
So we can experience that with each other. So I happened to make her as my fiance last year in June.
Oh, congratulations, congratulations.
So she was kind of nervous and crying at the same time.
So how did you propose to her?
I just got home, just started singing to her. And,
what was the song you sung to her?
Superstar.
Superstar.
Right, Ruben started the version.
Okay.
So.
All right.
Then I just got on one knee and just said, you know what, I'm just going to make her mine.
And did she know what was going on?
No.
She was total shocked.
Total shocked and total
that
like,
is
surprised.
Sweet. That's sweet. Okay.
Then nobody knew. She didn't know. Nobody else didn't know. But the fact, only me and the pastor knew.
Okay.
So, we got this plan now.
All right, that is so sweet. Now, are you on the road a lot?
Yeah, we go places all the time.
All the time, and she doesn't get worried or anything, right? That's good. That's good. Someone to, you know, be there and understand, you know, mm-hmm. what you got to go through, and not jealous. I know it gets hard sometimes, especially when you're on the road all the time, and. Sometimes us females, we get lonely and you know, we want our significant other. So that's good that she, you know, staying strong with you 20 years. Like, that's a blessing. So once again, congratulations, you know.
Thank you.
Any upcoming artists that are like not more in the game, you know, knee deep in the game than you, do you want to give them any advice, any encouraging words?
The only thing I would have to say is keep your head up and go strong with what you believe, you know. We all supposed to be supportive of our like people and
yes.
everything.
Yes, yes.
So
right.
My shout outs to y'all. And basically that's it.
Okay, all right. Well, can I get a little you know, do re mi fa so? You know, something.
Yeah, I can do a little bit.
Okay, let me get about, you know, 30 seconds of it.
It's time to turn the page. We both agree we need a seat in another way. Open up and finally communicate. To show respect and put some love in every word we see. No more wasting time. Here's a chance to put the pain and hurt behind. In this moment we dissolve and we define how we choose to love and treat each other kind.
There we go.
Oh, woo, woo, woo. Yes, okay. Make me want to be in love or something. Like, all right, I'm feeling that. All right, well, I thank you so much, you know, for all the encouragement words, you know, and the motivations, you know. So, next, we're going to bring up your other member.
Yeah, my single partner.
Yeah, single partner, okay. You know, and you said how long have y'all had y'all group?
Since 4 or 5 years now.
4 or 5 years? Okay. And y'all still close through everything now? Do you think the music brought y'all closer?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. Well, Tiger, I appreciate you coming on the show.
Thanks for having me on the show.
Spreading your gifts and everything. Everybody look out for the Three Kings. They're on YouTube, on SoundCloud. Okay. You know, everybody check that out. And you have safe travelings. You know, be blessed, not stressed. Okay. So, and I thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
And give a shout out to Toast It Up, you know. Give a shout out to one special person. When she's not here, it is Rasheen. So.
Okay, and that's the third member, right?
Third member.
Okay, shout out to him. So, even though he's not here, the second member of
the
Three Kings is here, yes. And I like to call him up now, all right? And can I get the second member of the Three Kings, John Meadows? Hello.
Hello, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Blessed, can't complain.
I know that's right. Let's not stress.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
You okay? Oh, when you called him. I heard you calling him. I got nervous for a second. Okay. How are you, John Meadows?
I'm all right.
Yeah, so, okay, so you just chose, I see you and the third member, Rasheen.
Yes, Rasheen.
Okay, so the first member wanted to be a little dangerous, Tiger. Right? Okay. So is there any reason behind you keeping your government name in the music group?
Well, I just don't believe in making up names.
Okay.
This is the name my mother gave me, so this is the name I would always go by.
All right, this is who you are. So, like, when you go and record this, they're getting the John Meadows, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So, that's good. So, do you believe, like, when did you start singing? Like, when was that a breaking point for you?
Let's say I've been doing it since 9, between drumming and singing.
Oh, a little drummer boy. Hey, okay. So, you were 9 when you started drumming?
Yes.
Okay. Now, were you in a church, or this was just like at home hobby type of thing?
No, it pretty much runs in the family. So okay. My cousin Reggie Dash was a drummer.
Okay.
And I would listen to him play, so then I started to play, and come to find out I was good at it. I just couldn't play a set.
Okay.
But I can play any marching percussion.
Any marching percussion. Okay. And you didn't take any class for that. That was just like an eye thing. You just caught on to it.
I can just do it.
You could just do it.
That's anything
it.
I put my mind to.
God-given talent. That's what's up. I can't do that. I can't even make a beat. So, you know, to do an instrument is very, that's a very God-given talent. So, and did you start singing as you started making your beats? Like during your beat making, were you singing along with it, making up songs?
Pretty much. It's like, can I explain this? My thing is, anything you can do with your mouth, you should be able to do with your hands.
Okay.
So if I'm making up little vibes with my mouth, then I should be able to do it with my hands. And I went on and on and on and on, and then I started to hum little tunes with it.
Okay.
And listening to my aunts and them sing, I would sing their songs and pretty much drum them out.
All right.
Since I couldn't hit their notes because I can't do female stuff.
Like no. You're more of like an alto?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right, so basically you know how to do the little beats then?
Yes.
All right, break out right now. Let me see a little beat. Let me get a little pattern. Little rum-tum-tum. Because I can't do it. But, you know.
What should I play? Oh, just marching. With the sticks, I can go even faster.
Well, let me tell you my beat. That was awesome. Thanks. I like that. That was awesome. So, Do you believe in, like, did you have a certain religion that you would play in? Like, did you go to church to play? What was your biggest event where you play the drums and sing at the same time?
I've never done both of them.
It was always one or the other?
Yeah, either I'm drumming with the unit or I'm singing the national anthem at some event.
Okay, all right. And what do you enjoy more?
Both.
They're both equal?
I can't write music without that being in my head. The beat has to be there.
Okay, all right. And do you have any kids?
Yes.
Okay, how many kids do you have?
Plenty.
Papa was a rolling stone? All right. Definitely
plenty kids.
Okay. Well, so are any of them musically inclined?
Yes, a few of my daughters sing.
Okay.
My son sings, and a few that rap.
Okay, got the love with the Jackson 7, 8. All right, just, you know, that's for a later date. Stay tuned, we'll find out how many kids. I think that's the wrong show, right?
No.
Going hard or something.
Don't let anybody know. I have 20 kids, 10 girls, 10 boys.
Praise Jesus, okay? There's a father that's proud. Thank you, God, all right? I know that's right, 20 kids. I probably know some of your kids.
I'm sure you do. They're all right here.
Mm-hmm. Well, damn, 20 kids. And would you mind telling us how old you are?
I'm 49.
49? That's beautiful. Be proud. Living 49, that's a God-given talent nowadays, too, because people are getting killed for nothing out here. So, yeah. I love birthdays. So, when's your birthday?
October 25th.
October 25th, Scorpio.
Yes, I am, to the heart.
November 4th. I want a birthday present, cake, something, all right. But, so you said that they're musically inclined. Now, were you with any of their mothers, or are you currently with any of their mothers? And do they sing as well?
No, not with their mothers.
Okay.
We're still friends.
That's good.
Yeah, we all stay close, even though we're not together, but we're all close.
That's good. And I think a big family, that's very important. So, is the Three Kings, are you guys like your own family in itself, too?
We'll say yes.
Yes? Oh, that's good. Okay. And you love them all equally, or do you have, like, a favorite?
Out of my children?
No, out of the Three Kings.
No, we're just cool. We're
all y'all are just cool.
We're cool.
Now, did y'all go to the same school? How did y'all make up your group? What year did you form your group, and how did it become one? How did y'all become one?
I'm not sure of the year, but I've knew Tim for years. I knew Rasheen for years, and just doing little different shows at Trenton High.
Okay.
Tim would always ask about us being a group.
Right.
Because I was with other groups.
Okay.
And never thought that we would actually hook up until we finally did.
Okay. And what were your other groups called?
I was with the Supernaturals.
The Supernaturals.
And I've done a lot of solo stuff where...
Okay.
That's why I said I use my name. I've been on the Apollo 9 times, never booed off.
Wow, okay.
I'm the backup anthem for the New Jersey Devils, Camden River Sharks, and Trenton Thunder. And
anything all right, now.
My name.
Yes.
Yeah, I would not change it.
I know that's right. Well, you got a lot of you got a lot of credentials behind your name, so I understand why you wouldn't change it. So that's what's up. So you did not get swept off the Apollo. That's a big deal, okay? You know I was supposed to be that clown that swept people off one day. One day, mama, I'm gonna make it, okay?
All you gotta do is sing what they wanna hear.
Oh, I'm not talking about singing. Okay. I wanna be the ease on down the road, that person, that clown, okay? I'm booing whoever, as soon as I hear a boo, I'm out there. Alright?
Yeah,
got to go. Yes.
He's coming for you.
I'm coming for you,
alright? Execution right now is C.P. Lacey. He's the tapper, he's the one that come out there and you got to go.
Oh yes, me and C.P., we got a meeting, alright? He got to go soon, alright? But
you gotta know how to tap too.
Tap what?
Because he does it all. He taps, sings, acts, everything. CP is the total package.
I crump though. Okay. I bet you don't even crump.
He can be look.
When with back, the broomstick too. Like, what's that? Listen, it's a new day and age. Like I said, CP got good.
All CP.
Right? Yeah. Okay.
CP Lacey.
CP Lacey, alright? Lisa Monet, nice to meet you. Anyway, so how many shows you and You and the Three Kings have performed?
Yeah, we've done plenty.
Plenty?
Yes, a lot. I can't even think of the number. We've done so many. Mainly, we end up doing most of the funerals right here.
Okay.
When somebody passed away, they reach out to us and we sing at the funerals.
Right. And what is your most common song for funerals that you get, that y'all have to sing together?
We did Coolie High Harmony or Boyz II Men song for Mom.
Okay. All right. Oh, that's my song. So, at the end of the day, do y'all see yourself going beyond New Jersey? Like, or do you think that this is just going, y'all going to stay local? Is there, like, a meaning behind y'all group? Like, I know some people, they don't do it for the fame, they don't do it for the fortune, but, you know, they just do it because they have a story to tell and they just want to get it out there. Do you think that's the principality of y'all group? Or y'all would like to, you know, put your mama on a hill and stuff like that? Like,
yes, I want it all.
Okay.
I want it all.
I know that's right.
I wish that I would have had this before my mother passed away, but I just lost my mother.
I'm sorry.
On the 15th, we buried her on the 28th, and I would have loved for her to see me actually get there.
Right. Well, trust me, she sees it. I don't know, you know, what higher power you believe in, but she sees it. I want to thank you so much. You know, you were very inspirational. I want to thank you so much for coming on Toasted Up.
You're welcome.
And I'm sure that you'll be here again, right?
Yes, I will.
Okay. And would y'all be willing to sing a little song for us as we close out?
Yes, I'll sing.
Okay. So, what will you be singing for us tonight?
Superstar by Luther Vandross.
Oh, Superstar Luther.
That's my
idea. All right. I think I was conceived on Luther. I don't know. You know, a chair is still a chair.
Well, this is Luther Vandross. Superstar.
Superstar. Let's do it.
I think you get in trouble getting married.
Oh, okay. Well, I gotta week, you know. And y'all take care. Remember, be blessed, be stressed with the host for the most, Lisa Monet, all about the Monet baby, okay? We out here. Deuces. Thank you.